The first one will be Franziska Sattler, that she's a paleontologist, and she will tell us why dinosaurs don't need a dentist. And we'll talk about dentation and tooth replacement in dinosaurs. And we are really looking forward to your talk. So are you ready?
Right. Yeah, as ready as I could be, I guess.
Okay, then the floor is all yours.
Okay. I'm going to show you in a little while why paleontologists need a lot of tech. So maybe we can just start, because whenever I talk to people about me being a paleontologist, that's what they picture. They picture me being in the field all the time, and it is a great part of the job, and I do enjoy it. You can see these great glamour shots of me doing field work. Most of that is in the United States a few years back. I haven't been for a little while for obvious reasons. But as you can see, there's lots of cool stuff involved. Sometimes we even do use brushes, just like in the movies, but not very often. There's lots of hammers and chiseling going on. But yeah, that's a small, very small part of the job of a paleontologist. If you are able with your body and have the resources to do field work, it's a great thing to do. But really, most of the time, it's something like that. I feel like this picture is very on brand. This computer is very old, but that was my first time looking at data and looking up stuff that I might need for my research, which I'm going to talk a little bit about in a little bit. So most of the stuff I do as a paleontologist, you have to be at the computer. Let me scroll down. Okay. I hope you can all see. The museum where I work here in Berlin, Museum of Naturkunde, they work very closely together with the Charité, where obviously like lots of people go when they have problems or they need surgery or whatever, you know. But at the weekends, every now and then, they do welcome dinosaurs to be scanned. So if you want to look at what's inside a dinosaur jaw, I'm going to show you what's inside in a little bit, but that's how you get to that. You have to CT scan, and it works just like how you do with humans. It goes in the CT scanner, and then we look at the pictures, and I use medical software that doctors use. So it's not very different from, you know, being a doctor, just being a dinosaur dentist. And what I'm really interested in when I look at these pictures is at tooth replacement in dinosaurs. And that is something that I'm still super interested in and that I love talking about. And when you, so I hope not many of you know that dinosaurs change their teeth continuously through their entire life. So we only do that once. We have baby teeth, then we get rid of them. And then usually we only have another set of teeth. Dinosaurs had a different strategy. They didn't have roots like we did. They mostly had teeth that were cone-like. You know, when you put when you put glasses on top of each other in the cupboard, you know, to save space, that's kind of how they managed that. They stacked their teeth inside their jaw, and they continuously grew and then pushed out the tooth so a new tooth would come. So you can see it a little bit in the slide, where a small tooth is always kind of there waiting to grow into that tooth and then push it out. What that looks like in the slides, I will show you. Let's see if it works. There we go. So when you do put the whole jaw inside the CT scanner and look at the pictures, this is what you will get when you look at sauropod dinosaurs. I have a little picture up down there. That was my first study subject. They're the ones with the really long necks and the very, very small head. They didn't really need a lot of thinking power. What they really had to do all day is eat. And the vegetation back then was quite different from how it is today. They had lots of conifers. I have a little picture there for you as well. Very coarse material and very rough. And dinosaurs didn't have fleshy cheeks like we do when we chew. In best case scenario, the food stays inside your mouth. Not so much when you're a sauropod dinosaur. What they did is they, like a garden rake, grabbed the vegetation, stripped it off the branches, and just swallowed it whole. What that does to a tooth is it wears it down very quickly. If there's constant strain and constant like coarse material rubbing off the tooth, I mean, it's tooth enamel, almost like we have today. And that just gets damaged and worn down and the tooth gets smaller and thinner continuously. To help that, dinosaurs, especially sauropods, they had these functional teeth. They're the biggest ones here. And then they had smaller teeth waiting inside the jaw. You can see it here a little bit. They're much smaller. Yeah. And sauropods replaced their teeth super, super quickly. The ones that I studied, they replaced their teeth every 20 days. So approximately every 3 weeks, a new tooth will come out. And that's the process that happens all the time. It's not like sharks where it's a new tooth comes when the old one falls out. This one is a continuous process. With that strategy, the animal makes sure that it can eat all the time without disruptions. Some of the animals replace their teeth, like there's one called Nigasaurus. Every 14 days, they would have a new functioning tooth. And that's why they have up to 4 teeth always waiting inside their jaw. So what you see here is a premaxilla. This one right here. And this is the maxilla. It's right here. Obviously, it's a little bit different than mammals, but I just wanted to show you what you're looking at. My more recent studies that I worked on was T-Rex. And T-Rex is obviously not a herbivore. It's a quite different strategy that they had. However, T-Rex also replaced its teeth. And when I first looked at these pictures, it blew my mind because, like I said, we don't really work a lot with a specimen, especially if it's in the exhibition. So what I did is just I continuously sat at this computer and looked at CT scans. And what I did, what has never really been done before in this scale, is look at the teeth, because very often we don't have very many left after, you know, millions of years. But we are very fortunate that Tristan Otto had 35 teeth, not even including the replacement teeth. So 45 teeth that I could measure and look at, see how large they are, see how large the replacement teeth are. And I have little errors there of what they look like inside the jaw. So as you can see, they're growing inside the already functioning tooth because they're mostly hollow. And sometimes people ask me, oh, isn't that a problem? Doesn't that mean that the tooth is not really like stable or really, you know, like secure? No, they go really deep into the jaw and they're very quite secure. And what's really cool about this is they replace their teeth more slowly, but it still happened every like approximately 2 years. And there is so much strain on the on like the whole head from obviously, no, the prey doesn't want to be eaten, or it's like bones will have to be crushed. So there's a lot of strain on it. The bad thing is if a tooth breaks off, which can happen, you know, all the time, a new tooth doesn't just come because the dinosaur needs it. It will have to wait until, you know, it's ready. And the replacement rate can be, I'm not going to bore you with all the details of how to measure that, but it is quite possible to find out by looking at the little lines growing on the tooth, kind of like a tree. If you count these, you can find out how old a tooth is. And if you have the measurements of how long they are, you can determine how many days that tooth has existed in the jaw. And that's the kind of work that I do. And if you ask yourself, oh, did only dinosaurs do that? That's really cool. Why don't animals do that today anymore? They actually do. We have crocodiles, and crocodiles on average replace their teeth once a year. And the older the animal, the slower the process. It's kind of like, you know, when you're older, things don't work so well anymore. And at the very end, before the animal like dies and reaches the ends of its life, then they don't replace their teeth anymore. So they have a similar strategy where the teeth are quite hollow, like a cone inside, and a new tooth will grow in and pop the old one out. And there will always be a functioning tooth in the jaw. what you see on the right is how sharks do it. They have a what they call revolver jaw, where they have a ton of teeth waiting there for you, you know. But their strategy is, as soon as one falls out, you know, because it's like it's time, or because there's lots of pressure or strain on that tooth and it just falls out, the new one automatically comes. But it's not a continuous process. It only comes when the old one is gone, if that makes sense. So it's a different strategy, but they still have replacement teeth. And just like T-Rex, crocodile did it like every once a year or like every 2 years, depending on the type of crocodile. But animals still do that today. And I think that is super cool. And I hope you didn't know that, because that's only something that I found out when I started studying it. And dinosaur teeth are awesome, and they're my favorite. And that's, I hope you could tell. And that's really all I have to say about that. I hope you could all see my slides, and I'm very excited for the next talks to come. And if you have questions, I will stop sharing my screen so I can see the chat now.
So thanks a lot, Franzi. That's, now we have time for some questions. So before I forgot to mention that, actually I'm quite happy to be able to present you, because only 1 month ago, it was the other way around. You were interviewing me, because Franzi has a SciComm platform or program every month called Café Clutch mit Wissenschaft, where she has a guest speaker every month. And it's like, yeah, like a chat on the couch talking about science and life as a scientist, and it's super cool. So I recommend it in case someone wants to follow it. And then here
usually
we have
the other around. Usually I'm interviewing others, so
yeah. So it's nice to have you here. So now we have several questions.